G'day, g'day, and welcome back to the channel. So I've just come back from test riding the BMW R1250RS, not the GS. Been watching some videos on the tube, and I thought, well, this is looking straight down my alley. That was a really nice experience. Let's just say that was just fantastic. Oh, man, oh man. So, yeah, I thought I'd duck down and test ride a bike that I've been quite keen on for a little bit. So, let's start from the beginning. When I thought about getting back into bikes, I didn't want to get into something that was going to kill me. Something that I could enjoy, that I could do some long trips in. And I was looking at doing the off-road thing. So the GS, so much stuff on YouTube about the GS, and that was what I focused on, and that's the path I went. And of course, I didn't want to spend too much money on getting into a bike and then finding out that I didn't want to do it. And after a few runs, I started to discover that I really had no inkling of going off-road, but I did want to do a lot of trips. And you've seen some of the other videos, done some really nice trips, just day trips, haven't done the overnighters yet. But there's something I miss, and it was when I went out with my mate Boxhead. We went to the pub down at Wiseman's Ferry, and I got some footage, but I still didn't have the audio set up. That's another story in itself. But what I discovered was that as much as I love the comfort and the feel of the GS, I still wanted something a bit sportier. And then seeing the RS pop up, a few people have ridden it. The Missenden Flyer took it for a blast, and I'm just starting to find some more people that have taken it for a ride. What's wrong with me today? And they all seem to like it as well. So it looked like a good option. It looks like a good option. Finally, I was able to go and take it for a run. So here's the review. Go and have a look at this. Let's take the BMW R1250RS for a ride. And yeah, check this out. This is very nice indeed. So I'll keep the visor down. I'm getting a little bit of fog in the sun visor. There we go. So first impression, just cruising around the back streets. Nice and light and nimble. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to want to get back on the GS after this. I don't know. Got to wait for people to stop because you don't know what they're doing. Anyhow. So here we are, the BMW R1250RS, and straight away I got very comfy position. I like where it's at. It's quite tight. I'm gonna head over Stockton Bridge, open her up a little bit, see what she's like. I'll pop this up. Oh, it's already up. You go down and up, very easy. Actually, that's easier than the GS, I reckon. Oh, that shift is good. Oh dear, gotta watch that throttle because that'll open up real quick. So the RS gives the option of doing some touring, 18, 19 litre tank, something like that, and but with a bit more sporty feel to it, which I think is something I'm missing from all my riding at the moment. So I'm quite keen to just try this out to see what it's like. God, it's smooth. BMW they just know how to do it right, don't they? I mean, how nice is this? This is beautiful. Low to the ground, flat-footed, feel really, really stable on the ground at the moment. That That shift is beautiful. Look at it. And I'm actually feeling really comfy. I'm loving this TFT screen. It'd be really good though if I could actually get off that menu screen. Oh, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. Because I've not had the chance to play with this TFT at all. I've not seen one, I've not mucked. I mean, the Super Duke R was good, but the Beamer you just hear so much about. So, is this guy going to let me through? What do you reckon? Yeah, this is cool. Thoroughly enjoy it. So you got the GPS set up, ready to rock and roll, which I do like that there actually. Push button. TFT is just magic at the moment, so plenty of range. So for an 18 litre tank, I reckon I could handle an 18 litre tank. Shaft drive, sporty feel. Everything's up the front. With the mirrors further forward, there's a bit more, like you don't need to look so hard. I do like the feel. I like the fact that you're low down. It'd be interesting to see if I raise the seat up a little bit more, but the problem with that is that you're going to hit more wind and probably a bit more pressure on the arms as well. And it just wants to play. It just wants to play big time. So you still got the header grips, the road modes. What mode are we in at the moment? Holy crap, it's got dynamic. Well done, BMW. Well done indeed. I think you've definitely outdone yourself with the 1250 RS. I think I've just put this at the top of my list of bikes to have. Okay, so why don't we make our way back to Bryson's, say thanks to Kev, back over the bridge, into second. Oh, this thing pulls like no other. So being the 2019 model, I wonder what the 2020 is going to be like. Obviously it's going to be way too expensive for this man to afford, but you know something? I'm quite keen. I don't know if you can see that down there. That's the steering dampener that BMW have quietly hidden. That is a winner in my books as well. I really love the fact that they've got that. That's awesome. Oh, those mirrors are in the perfect spot too. Yeah, okay. Winning. So there you go. This is the 2019 BMW R1250 RS. This is on my number one, definitely my number one for ownership, if I could have anything. This is a sports tourer. This feels amazing. Absolutely amazing. So I'm loving this at the moment. Look at that. Within no time, you've just got perfect control. Doesn't have the SOS, which is interesting. I thought we would have had it. Maybe it's a European thing, not an Australian thing. Put that back up. How easy is that? Instead of this, you know, fiddly little knob thing. I love this finish. Yeah, look. Very comfortable. Very, very comfortable indeed. I think I've found my favorite bike. I reckon I could ride this for hours on end any day. You want to sit upright? There you go. I'm sitting upright, can swap hands around. So if you're doing those freeway runs, you know, you can sit upright a little bit more. You still got plenty of room to get to the handlebars. The height's good, knees feel good, legs feel good. Bit more wind, because it's not such a big fairing like the GS. But that's okay, I don't mind it. There it is. Okay. Yep. Quite impressed. Quite impressed indeed. Looks good. Nice, small, nimble little thing. Very tight. Very tidy. All right. Well, that's it. We'll go and jump back on the GS and head home. So there you go, that's the BMW R1250RS, which now sits right on the top of my list of bikes I want right now. It is the only bike. I'm in love with it. I think that was beautiful. I want these foam grips though for it. I find these really comfy. They're really nice. That's just, you know, the softness of me coming out because I like to be comfortable. But yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed that short ride. It was only a short blast around, and I might take another one for a run, just get another feel for it. That was the exclusive. I love the blue. Blue's really nice. The plans for that would still be to get panniers. You know, I've got some gear, the Nelson Rig Touring tail pack for the pillion seat. Certainly going down that path to grab one of those. And a few other bits and pieces as well, but that'll be later on down the track. I've got to get the bike first, but just a beautiful bike indeed. So I really enjoyed that ride. That was a lot of fun, and I'm just glad I've got my passion back for riding. Actually, it's good. This old girl's been a beast. She's been fantastic. But I just want that sporty. I want something a bit sporty. And I think the RS is, well, not think, I know, after riding it, I know that's what I'm going to want. So that is it. That's the BMW R1250 RS. That's on the list. Hey guys, just want to say thanks for joining us on the channel. I hope you've hit that subscribe button, like these videos, check them out. They are slowly getting better. I would love to see you become more of the community that we're trying to grow here. Join my Patreon page, the link's just up there, and we'll get some special content out. We've got so much happening coming up with some great rides lined up out through the Hunter Valley. We're going to be doing the putty out to go and see Kim at Grey Gums Cafe. We're going to be ducking down to Sydney, doing a bit of the South Coast, and looking forward to Seacliff Bridge. And we're just going to get out and have some fun. So stick around, make sure you join me, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to hit that notification bell too, so you know when a video comes out. They're going to be pretty random at the moment, just when I get some material. And if there's anything you'd like to see, throw a comment below, say hi, and let's get out there and have a bit of fun.